Welcome to Minity Maths. In this video, we will explore the set theory operations of union, intersection, difference, and complement. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. Let's start with the basics. A set is simply a collection of distinct objects with something in common, which we call elements. Here are some examples. We use set notation to represent these collections in a clear and concise way. A set is usually denoted by a capital letter, such as A or B, and the elements within the set are enclosed in curly braces and separated with commas. The elements do not have to be in any specific order. Here, A is the name of the first set, and the elements inside the curly braces are the odd numbers. B is the name of the second set. The elements of the set are prime numbers. Sets are powerful tools, and we can perform operations on them. Set operations are performed on two or more sets to obtain a combination of elements depending on which operation is performed on them. Let's look at one such operation, named union. Union combines all unique elements from both sets. In this example, we have the union of A and B. Notice that numbers are only written once, even if they appear in both sets. Let's look at these same examples using a Venn diagram displaying set A and set B. For a union, we merge these numbers from both sets together. This results in a new set that contains all elements from A and all elements from B. No duplicates, no extra elements. It's like merging two lists together. Next up, we have the intersection operation. Given sets A and B, the intersection, denoted with an upside-down version of the union symbol, contains only the elements that exist in both sets. Again, let's look at the process of set intersection with a Venn diagram. Think of it as finding the common elements between A and B. This is useful in various real-world scenarios, like finding shared characteristics in a group of people. Now let's look at another set operation, difference. As the name suggests, we are finding the difference between sets. We denote difference using the minus symbol. In this example, the difference, denoted as A minus B, includes all elements that are in A, but not in B. Have a look at this Venn diagram. If we create an intersection of A and B, we can take away the elements that occur in set B. We can see that the elements 1 and 9 are included in set A, but not set B. Finally, we have the complement operation. Here, we need to understand what a universal set is. A universal set, often denoted as U, is a concept in set theory that represents the entire or complete set of all possible elements relevant to a particular context or problem. It essentially encompasses everything that needs to be considered for a specific scenario. For example, if you're working with sets of colors, the universal set might include all the possible colors in existence. If you're dealing with sets of numbers, the universal set could be the set of all real numbers. Here, the universal set contains all integers from 1 to 10. So given a universal set U and a subset A, the complement of A contains all elements in U that are not in A. In other words, the complement of A includes everything that is outside of set A, but within the universal set U. This operation is handy when you want to express what's not in a particular set. Have a look at this Venn diagram to demonstrate. We have the universal set of numbers from 1 to 10. Inside the circle, we have all the elements in set A. So anything outside the circle but within the universal set is classed as the complement of A. That's all for now. We have covered the fundamental set theory operations: union, intersection, difference, and complement. These operations help us analyze and manipulate sets in various mathematical and real-world scenarios. Have a go at these practice questions using the Venn diagram and pause the video while you work them out. Thanks for watching, check out the channel for more videos.